this talk is about some maximum state politics in Denmark. I have done during this year. And the core collabora, you probably know this talk already. We made Libra Fespanima, that is on the Mac App Store. It's, as the name Manila says, it's Libra Fespanima from upstream, from TDF, but if you run Sandbox, and that can be sold on the App Store. And because it's Sandbox, it's more secure than the normal one. It can't access ticket, it shouldn't be able to access and so on. And this app generates small revenue stream that we use to do some bug fixing on for Mac. And also part of the proceeds are donated to TDF. So let's jump into these bugs. The first one, I couldn't find a bug number for it as such, probably there is one, but I didn't mention it in the commits. LibreOffice was quite slow to start on a Mac, and also when you open a writer window and started typing into the document, there was a clear delay before you saw the first character show up. And a large part of this delay was caused by this OSL open file function that for the Mac contains code that looks up in the file as a sort of alias. And these aliases are sometimes of siblings that have some smart behavior additionally. And doing this lookup apparently takes significant time, so if you don't do it for 4 files that are inside the bundle, it helps a lot. And actually, I'm not sure that I actually need to do this alias check, because I haven't myself ever intentionally created an alias file or an alias for the bundle, but you have. Okay, so then it's just not useful. And the next one was about this crash on startup of some machines. This was related to a notification about display layout or display arrangement that on some machines, for some reason, the system sent to the application as soon as you asked for this notification. And our handler for this notification wanted to use VCL, but we hadn't yet initialized VCL, so naturally this was not a good thing to do. The simple question, fix was simple. Don't do it before you have this initialized. Then there was another one related to this chain notification. If you had like 5 or 10 documents open, and you minimize the graphics, then you got for a very long time very high CPU usage. And this was also this notification that we got, and but not on all systems, just for some. And the handler for this notification, it started relay out in all open documents, which of course is quite time consuming, and in most cases nothing had actually changed when we got this notification. So the fix was to have some state to the handler and check if something has changed or not. Then we come to the full screen stuff that has been quite interesting. As you know, LibreOffice itself has this full screen concept Victoria and Bertiani. Then the mid-sized boat occupied the whole Serena, which shows a small floating window that close to the limit. And macOS 7 also has a full screen concept. You get in it if you press the green bubble. And these are not separated, not in sync, so you will put the document window in the full screen from the LibreOffice point of view, but not from the system point of view, and then also from the system point of view, but then return from the LibreOffice point of view, but it will still be full screen, because it was from the system point of view, and stuff like that. It was quite confusing. So, I assume that the fix would be to unify these two concepts and just have one that would be in parallel. Unfortunately, this led to some migrations like this one that Impress didn't run full screen anymore, which was of course not ideal. So I didn't have that much time to spend on this, but I revert to this unification. And instead then I dropped this attempt to allow LibreOffice to participate in this system for screen mode. Which is not ideal either, but it's better than a lot more than a confusing situation. But of course, Baxilla users are not like this and they complain over this one version. But ignore the haters. And here is another where the CPU got stuck consuming lots of time for practical no reason. Then you had the about level open end and you quit your rows. And I think I'm going to fix this to call this underscore exit function. Just bypass all the global object destructors. Then this was quite interesting. If you open the document by double clicking the binary instead of opening from LibreOffice or from business command O, then it would take quite a long time before the document actually opened. And the reason for this was that the handler for this request from the system to open a file didn't actually do much, it just put the request into the list. And this list was checked just once every 10 seconds. So it could take maximum 10 seconds for it to actually open. And here the fix was also quite simple, just call this function that causes the file to be open directly in this open files. And here I use the node method because it's an Objective-C class, and it's a fast class. And some more full screen. Goodness. If you close the document as a full screen mode in LibreOffice, it's all full screen mode, then the menu bar somehow didn't appear anymore. And the fix here was to leave the full screen mode before closing the document. And this one is also quite interesting. If you, in Calc, if you copy a column or several columns and then quit, then LibreOffice tries to store a selection into the clipboard, system clipboard, and it does that in several formats on all systems. All platforms, and for some formats it tried to store all column 1 million rows, like PhD for Harvard. Of course, that requires one kind of generate such a limitation. So we don't do that anymore, but only for the relevant parts of the community, like it already did for some other platforms. And this was another thing that caused a long delay after typing the first character into the writer. This was noticeable only if you had and in still checking which now is installed. So it was not easy or not trivial to see for a developer who typically don't have dictionaries. And it was caused by this light proof tool that is written in Python and is used for some languages, for instance, Brazilian Portuguese. And when you initialize that, it loaded a very long Python script, actually some data for Brazilian. And the fix was to not load it until actually needed. There was this Python import delay or something that can be used instead of the import.
Between minus one and one, if I remember correctly. And we had a
not that different things in the same, same level of respect. Then this big group thing that we find out if we select a file and press space bar, you see like a preview of the document contents. That's not implemented at all when it comes currently. So LibreOffice could provide a system, what they call it, a system volume system extension to handle this big look for those document types that LibreOffice knows but the system doesn't know. And related to this is also Spotlight, the thing that indexes your files and provides search for them. And of course, the performance can always be improved. That's all. Thank you.